हेलो एवरीबॉडी, आई तुषार जैन, CFO एंड रिसर्च हेड ऑफ अजय एस्ट्रोमनी गुरु। वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टुडे ऑन 12th November 2021। इन दिस एपिसोड आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट माई व्यूज ऑन इंडियन स्टॉक मार्केट एंड वॉट ऑल थिंग्स यू नीड टू कंसिडर फॉर नेक्स्ट फ्यू ट्रेडिंग डेज। सो बिफोर कमिंग टू द इंडियन मार्केट्स, लेट अस फर्स्ट लुक एट द अदर मेजर इंडाइज इन द अदर मेजर स्टॉक मार्केट्स। येस्टरडे the US markets were volatile. The Dow Jones was down while the Nasdaq was up, which shows that the IT companies was up in the US market yesterday. Also, if we see the day before yesterday, the US market fell because of the inflation issues, and the inflation rates has been declared day before yesterday, and it came at the level of 6.2%, and this much high inflation is already been discounted by the American markets day before yesterday. Therefore, no major impact have been seen in the yesterday's market. But if we see the Indian markets yesterday, they were highly volatile and weak. And the if we see the Nifty and Bank Nifty both crossed the previous day's lows and have been seeing significant profit booking. And especially the banks, whether it is private sector banks or public sector banks, almost all the major banks have been seen profit booking in the yesterday's session. Also, if we see the FIIs are continuously selling in Indian markets, and yesterday also they sold by around 1637 crores in cash market, while the DIIs net bought only by 445 crores in cash market. So in spite of any positive news or strength in the Indian markets, the FIIs are continuously selling, especially from last 1 month. Although the Infosys, TCS, Reliance, these were the stocks which were supporting Nifty yesterday, and if they were also down, then the Nifty might have seen more 100 to 150 points fall in the yesterday's session. Also, yesterday the Shipping Corporation of India's news that the news of Shipping Corporation of India disinvestment, as the government of India, that is the Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways, and Niti, along with Niti Aayog, wants to sell the non-core assets of the company, or that is of the Shipping Corporation of India, as a demerger, as a disinvestment. And this process is expected to be done at last by the end of December. Also, the Indian Hotels is also coming up with its rights issue, and the total number of equity shares will be around 13.21 crores, and the right issue size will be around 1982 crores. And the right issue price will be 150 for the fully paid up equity share. And if we see the current market price of Indian Hotel, it is at the level of 211.45, and the right issue price will be 150 per share, which is the 61 rupees difference. And the entitlement ratio will be 1 equity share for every 9 fully paid up equity shares. So it is a nice opportunity for the shareholders of Indian Hotel to apply for its right issue. And now if we see the market situation, since tomorrow and day after tomorrow will be Saturday, Sunday and weekly off, therefore it is advised to go for stock specific trades rather than index specific. So you can consider Steel Authority of India, Hindalco and ONGC. These three stocks are expected to show some positive move in the next few trading days. And also, since the Shipping Corporation of India is coming up with a disinvestment, you can consider it for the two or three months perspective. It is expected to give good return in next 2 to 3 months. So that's all for the today's episode. See you in the next episode. Thank you and good day.